Do we want to get rocked?
I'm Cliff Pike, you're watching a very special edition of Caps TV from the Holiday Inn at Carstorphine, the launch of hockey's homecoming. Gentlemen, a huge day today for the Edinburgh Capitals with the launch of the hockey's homecoming tournament. Tell us a little bit, Scott, about how the tournament came around.
Well, over the last two or three years I've been trying to put together some sort of tournament and We never seemed to be able to get the right doors opened, and what happened was I just simply got in contact with the president of the AHL, who has luckily Scots descent too, and we started chatting, and he came back and said, "Yeah, we'll come over." So I immediately panicked, phoned up Willie, said they're wanting to come over.
No, what do we first, Scott? You say you swore, and then you say, "What we're going to do now?"
So it was such a great honour that these teams were going to come over and play in Scotland, and particularly our building. So I got on to Willie and said, "We have to make this happen one way or another. This is a huge opportunity for ice hockey, not just in Scotland but the UK. Two well-established teams." Are willing to come over and be part of a Homecoming Scotland event. So Willie started opening doors and started getting us talking to people that believed, and it developed from there. And then we brought in an events team, Cherry Picker Events, and they helped coordinate a lot of the other stuff in the background. But remarkable amount of organisation that Willie and we've all been helping to put together, and it's just going to be a remarkable experience.
Tell us a little bit, Willie, about the two Canadian teams involved, the Hamilton Bulldogs and the Toronto Marlies.
Well, they're teams that will play at a different level that we would ever hope to play at normally. They've decided to come over, the two largest franchises in North America. Of course, they're linked to the Canadiens and the Maple Leafs. And it's exactly the level that we thought we wouldn't get. When we first discussed this, it was like, maybe go for the East Coast Hockey League, something like that. Scott made the pitch to the league. A lot of things came together at the right time for us. Scotland's year of homecoming has been important in this. The people in Canada who are of Scots descent have been important in this, saying, "Yes, let's do this, let's go for this." And the Edinburgh Council have been absolutely fantastic with us on this event to make sure that it can actually happen. There's been a lot of sleepless nights. It's been half a dozen times where Scott says, "No, this isn't going to happen. We can't do it. We can't afford to do it. It's not going to happen." And then we've ploughed on, we've got there, we've got the support of sponsors. We want to go out and get more support of sponsors. More importantly, we want to get the fans from all over the UK and beyond coming to this event. It's not just going to be a few games of hockey. It's going to be a total event. We're looking at having marquees for beer tents. We're going to have a Kelly here in the Holiday Inn on the Saturday night. They're one of our sponsors as well. This will be the team's hotel, and also fans can book here. So we're making a total event for hockey fans, the likes we've never seen in the UK. It will surprise a lot of people, particularly our friends down south. I'm sure Dave Sims at the moment sitting there thinking, "How on earth did they manage to do that?" So good on you, Dave. We did it and you didn't.
It is quite an achievement, Scott, for a club like the Capitals to be able to put on a tournament like this. We're sometimes perceived as the poor relations in the league, but it's a major coup for us, this one.
Well, it is, and I don't think it's just a remarkable experience for potential hockey fans. This is something for all sports fans. I've only witnessed one AHL game in the Charlottetown Forum in Prince Edward Island, and it was absolutely remarkable. It was a building similar to Edinburgh, and this is where I think Edinburgh's ideal, in that it's a smaller arena, but it has the intimacy and has the atmosphere, and the speed and intensity that these teams I witnessed in Charlottetown, it was quite remarkable. And I think any sports fan having the opportunity to see these teams in action will be instantly attracted to the sport. It is a remarkable experience.
The Marlies and the Bulldogs, Willie, though, affiliated to the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Montreal Canadiens, two of, if not the two biggest names in ice hockey in North America. That's the standard of players that we're going to be up against. How do you think the Caps and the Belfast Giants will fare against them?
Do you want me to be honest, or do you want me to put the spin on it?
Be honest.
Well, what we're going to do is, when they first arrive, we're going to kidnap half their team, right, and put them in our jerseys. Yeah, we're going to give them a game. You know, we'll be a few games into our season. This is their pre-season. But you bring in guys over who are hungry to be in the AHL, who'll step up their game. We're going to play as well as we can against them. I'm sure the Giants will fancy their chances. Once we have a squad of players together at the start of the season, we'll fancy our chances as well. And I think it's going to be this entertainment value for everybody that's important. This legacy is what we've spoke about a lot. This is about building a legacy now for the Caps. Got the event. Get the people through the door, get old Caps fans, old Racers fans through the door, but get new fans to hockey. Let them know that there's ice hockey in Edinburgh, let them know there's a good standard of ice hockey in Edinburgh. Enthuse them, bring them along, see the event, and come back game after game after game to follow the Edinburgh Capitals throughout the season.
A huge opportunity as well, Scott, to form relationships with these clubs. And obviously every season we're looking to bring players into the Capitals, bring them to Edinburgh to play in the Elite League. Is that something that you'll be looking to try and foster with these clubs with this tournament?
Without a doubt. I'm a believer that we have to try and produce players of the calibre that can go further than the UK. Guys that can maybe follow in the footsteps of Charlie Gardner. We can only do that by providing our players with the best possible conditions and training to be able to do that. And I think that's what the Capitals, whilst we're not winning cups, what we are achieving is we're providing opportunities for our young Brits to at least have a chance of developing to the highest level that they can. Our kids are on the ice four times a week playing, two games at the weekend. These opportunities for training were not available even in the days of the Murrayfield Racers. Now these guys like Mark Garsay, Ben O'Connor, Jordan Steele, it's a fantastic opportunity for them to be experienced at the sort of highest level of the game. I was just thinking the other night, I would love to be playing in this game if I could get my whole body back into shape.
Doug, you might get a game.
it's just a fantastic opportunity for these young Brits and their imports, because a lot of them will be absolutely it'd be a mouth-watering experience for them playing against these AHL teams. But we've got a lot of young Scots kids in particular, and we've got the relationship with Dino Bauba, the coach of the Brayhead Paisley Pirates, and it will be we'll probably be doing a number of two-way deals with some of their young British players. So it could well be that they find themselves on the roster for this weekend. It's just a fantastic opportunity all around for these players to be playing against the calibre of this competition.
Scott mentioned briefly there, Willie, Chuck Gardner. Now, Homecoming Scotland obviously involved with this tournament. Chuck Gardner, an Edinburgh guy who went over to Canada, he made a bit of a name for himself in the game.
Yeah, the roaming Scotsman, that's not a bad name to be given. He went over when he was seven, wasn't the greatest of skaters, as most Scottish people at that time weren't, went in goals and developed his own very Scottish style. When we were doing the research on him, there's a fantastic quote when he's asked about why he's such a good goalie, and he said, well, I play baseball, so that might be part of it. However, I'm Scottish, I don't give up one goal without a fight. And that's the kind of the spirit he had. The famous story about him in the Stanley Cup final, where it went to game five at that stage to win the cup, it was 0-0, and he told these guys, we just need to score one goal, I'm not letting any in. Double overtime, he was in bits, pucks flying all over the place, he held it together, puck goes down the ice and the Blackhawks win it. Charlie Gardner becomes a hero. He's the only person who's a captain to a goalkeeper captain a team to the Stanley Cup, the Hockey Hall of Fame, Canada's top 100 sportsman, and a Scottish legend.